glad to be here. It's good to be here. It's always good to get a hug from Miss Kitty. So, yeah, yeah. Hi, Miss Kitty. The Astoria Rescue Mission, just to let you know this, we do have a gentleman in the hospital right now. He came to the mission about 4 or 5 months ago. At that point, he had been about a year before that. They had given him a year to live. They said he wasn't gonna make it past 6 months from about a year and a half ago. But he's hung on this long. Right now, they have put 35 stents in him over the last year or so. And they've said, well, we can't do any more. The best they can do right now is pain management for him, which is what he just went to the hospital today. So I would be very grateful if everybody just kept Bill in your prayers, and also with your indulgence. And as soon as we get done here, we're going to skedaddle to the hospital to be able to be with him and pray with him. So at the Astoria Rescue Mission, we are very grateful for all of our wonderful donors, and we're grateful for your support. We serve about, just statistics, we serve about 900 meals a month, probably about 300 night stays right now. We have 5 men on our program. A few of them are here right now. I know John, raise your hand. Are you here? There you are. Okay. He's going to get it up here in a minute and give a testimony. We've done a lot of remodeling at the mission too. If you come in there and ever see it, I don't know if you've been seeing it maybe a couple of years ago, but we put in a whole brand new kitchen. We put in new floors. We've taken out all the carpeting, and so it's we put in a new wraparound porch around the outside, so we don't have that steep hill going down anymore. We've done a lot of work there, and all that stuff is because of the great donations that we get, and the prayers and the generosity of all of our of you, actually. Yeah, thank you. We have been going out and doing lunches on the street, but I've been negligent in coming here and getting the and getting here on time and getting the boxes. It's been really busy. I'm hoping to start that up one of these days. I'll be able to get out there and help contribute to that ministry and seeing that the needs of the people on the streets are taken care of as well. We do have showers, of course, and we have laundry available for people. We have anybody that comes in can always avail themselves to those things as well. We do have, in our Christian discipleship program, people come in and they are in search of something, hopefully. And when they get there, they find the Lord, hopefully. And people ask me, what is your success rate at the mission? I always tell them 100%. Because if anybody adheres to what we teach there, which is Christ, how can you fail? So our success rate, if they adhere to the teaching of the Lord, is always 100%. So we're just very grateful. I'm going to ask John to come up. He's going to give a testimony. Thank you, John. Yeah. Now this is John Swenson, one of our discipleship members.
Kind of uncomfortable. I don't really want to be here, but then I thought, well, if it glorifies God, then that's fine. I felt as I was coming in, I was thinking, boy, I don't deserve to be here. But then I remember Jesus, and it all points to him that I'm going to talk about it, proclaim him. My story of salvation is really in my whole life. I grew up in a Christian family, so I came into contact with his word a long time ago. I was just a little kid. My mom, she She passed away pretty early. I had a hardness of heart. I didn't stay in the church. I started doing my own things. I didn't give those things to the Lord. A lot of things that would happen. I didn't always respond the best way either. But I held on to a lot of things I shouldn't have held on to. And it went that way for a lot of years. Some people have different stories, different addictions and things, but I had my own. A lot of people who come to the mission, there's a lot of drug problems. I had a similar problem that kept me locked up and really away from people. I was walking in a lot of despair and hurt. I had no hope. I didn't look ahead. That's what happened. It wasn't going anywhere. Then a couple of years ago, something happened. It was a hard place I was in, and I cried out to Jesus because I remembered growing up with my family, and I remembered church. So I cried out to him. And I remember questioning him. I remember that. It's kind of like the Lord was telling me, I'm still here, whether you see that or not. The next year I spent reading the Bible, exploring it. I remember growing up, the Bible was so foreign to me. It was like a different language. I had such a hard time understanding it. I think that contributed to just not going to it. It was so weird. But that year I spent reading it, I had some hunger for it. I got to read this. And I just was pouring through it. I still haven't read the whole thing. The Lord recently led me to start reading the Old Testament. So I've been starting in there, and right now I'm in Leviticus. A year later, I ended up quitting my job, and I've never been more broken in my life. That's the moment when I fell on my knees and I just prayed to God. I just spilled it all out, everything. And I asked him to forgive me, and something changed. I still remember that. I mean, I think about it all my life, everything's happened. I can't remember the days, the times. Things get fuzzy. But I remember the day and the time of that, and that's when it became clear to me. And the Lord spoke to me and just told me to keep my eyes on him. And I've been through a lot of ups and downs since then. I'm still going through ups and downs, but he shows up, and he's always strengthening me. Sometimes it's with his word, and sometimes other people, events, things are happening, things that that come over me. Even yesterday, I had a hard time yesterday. I felt that I should have prayed for somebody, so I was really praying about that. And then somebody came by. And I was like, okay, so I know this guy, we were doing some stuff, he actually, I guess he's going to church today, I don't know where, but somewhere, and he'll praise the Lord. But somewhere in him, he's listening to the Lord. So I went out there and was with him a while, and then I hit that same place, the same spot I was in earlier. I was like, should I go over there and pray for him? I just felt the Lord was nodding. So I went over and prayed for him. And then I got back, and I was just overwhelmed by his grace. That's happened to me before. He just shows up with things. And so many times I felt like, Lord, who am I? I'm not anybody. And I'm standing up here, and I'm Just like all of you, a sinner who needs a Savior. Thank you, Jesus Christ, my Savior, my Lord, and my God. And His grace is amazing. It's every day, daily, every day. Give it to Him, every single thing. So my hope is that there was a slide on the screen earlier. It showed a creek, living water, that everybody would believe and have that living hope in Christ and never have to thirst or hunger again forever. And just everybody, that's my hope and that's my prayer, to be led by His Holy Spirit in all things. The old man is dead, dead and gone. Thank you, Lord. And Bill isn't here now, but I know he told me of something that happened to him. He was in the hospital a while back, and he said that just something came over him, a peace. He was praying, and he said the Lord just filled him, and it's like complete peace came over him, and he fell asleep. And I don't know what's going to happen, but I know that here or there, he's with Christ, and God will take care of him. And I have Michael over here. He's been with us a while, and we fellowship a lot. I really like his company. Pray for us. Lord's will is done in all things. People see His light. And that's all I got. Sorry.
Thank you, John. So we have a group of guys at the house that, you know, I praise God because we have Bible studies every morning and we have chapel every evening. But sometimes what I don't see is people in the Word all the time. But these guys that we have right now, they're always in it, always looking, searching the Bible for truth and looking for God's answers. And I just praise God for that. But we have a group of guys there that want to know the Lord, that want to do right, that want to have their lives changed. And I just praise God for that. And the reason we can do that, once again, because of you. Because it's people like you that help keep these doors open and help us make it possible for us to provide those needs for the men that come to us. And so I thank you very much for that. And make sure you keep Bill in prayer, because we're gonna head out now, and we're going to go be with him and pray with him. And because this, I do worry because they gave him 6 months, and so I do have that worry in my mind that every time he goes to the hospital, it might be the last time. So. But like John said, he has come to that point where he knows God, and he has a peace, and he knows to be absent from the body and be present with the Lord. So there isn't that trepidation or that fear that a lot of people have. He knows who his Father is. So, amen. Thank you very much.